Hey everybody, welcome back. This is the last video on radiation interactions. Here we'll be talking about Compton scattering. This is the most common but the least desirable photon interaction. So here's what happens. The X-ray photon enters an atom in the body, and the X-ray photon energy is partially absorbed by a loosely bound outer shell electron. This results in the electron being knocked out of its orbit, which we call ionization. The electron is commonly called a Compton electron because it was created by Compton scattering. The rest of the photon energy immediately exits the atom as a scattered photon. It has less energy than the original photon, and it's going in a different direction. That's why we call it scatter. So with Compton scattering, it's a photon in with an electron and a scattered photon out. Make sure and understand how Compton scattering is different from the other interactions. With photoelectric effect, this interaction takes place in an inner shell electron, and it results in only an ionized electron. There's no scattered photon. Coherent scattering is also different. This occurs when the incident photon interacts with the entire atom. The energy of the photon is temporarily absorbed and then released as a scattered photon. There's no ionization, no free electron, and no biological harm. Once again, Compton scattering occurs when the incoming photon interacts with an outer shell electron. This energy is absorbed by the electron, which causes it to be knocked out of its orbit. At the same time, a scattered photon is also created. So, what are the effects of Compton scattering? Remember the three areas that we should be concerned with: patient dose, the bystander dose, and image quality. Compton scattering affects all three areas, and none of these effects are good effects. We'll start by talking about the patient dose. The effect of Compton scattering on patient dose is not good. Remember that Compton scattering does result in ionization. So this free electron that gets created crashes through the surrounding tissues and cells and results in biological damage in the body. The scattered photon can also be absorbed in the patient's tissues, which causes even more harm and more dose to the patient. All of this results in an increase in the patient's dose. Compton scattering also has a negative effect on the bystander dose, such as the radiographer. The reason this happens is because Compton scattering, according to its name, creates scatter. This scatter sometimes strikes the image receptor, but it very easily can strike the radiographer. In fact, Compton scattering is the number one source of technologist dose. Last of all, Compton scattering also has a negative effect on the image. So why is that? Compton scattering, of course, creates scatter, which in turn decreases the image contrast. Remember this principle. The combination of photoelectric effect and transmission creates what would otherwise be a high contrast, high quality image. And what we mean by this is there's clearly visible differences in the shades of gray. Compton scattering, and really any kind of scattering, adds meaningless noise to the image. When we add scatter, such as Compton scatter, to the image, this results in an overall decrease in the image contrast. So when does Compton scattering occur? Remember this principle. More matter equals more scatter. For example, part thickness. With more matter in the way, more photons interact by Compton scattering. This is the main reason that larger patients, as in the example to the right, have more scatter and therefore lower image contrast. More Compton scatter is created in the thicker patient. There's more matter, therefore more scatter. The same idea applies to part density or tissue density. This refers to the amount of matter packed into the space of the tissue. The chest is mostly full of air, which is lower density, which means there's less matter and less scatter. The abdomen, though, is approximately the same thickness but much more dense. This means there's more matter, more scatter, and the overall image is going to be lower contrast. One more way we apply this principle is in regards to the field size or the amount of collimation. If we decrease the collimation or use a larger field size, there's more matter being exposed, therefore more scatter and lower contrast. One more factor that influences the amount of Compton scattering taking place is the beam energy, which of course is controlled by the KVP. If we increase the KVP, This proportionally increases the amount of scatter and therefore decreases the total image contrast. The ideal situation would be to have as little scatter radiation as possible. So how can we reduce the amount of Compton scatter? Consider these factors. We could decrease the part thickness. We do this by compressing the patient, if possible. We would also want to use the smallest field size or the most collimation possible. And last of all, when we can, we'd want to use a lower KVP. All of these factors together decrease the amount of Compton scatter taking place. Obviously, this is the ideal, but sometimes this isn't possible. Here's a summary of Compton scattering. Compton scattering occurs when the incoming photon interacts with a loosely bound outer shell electron. The electron is going to be immediately knocked out of its orbit. This process is called ionization, and the free electron is sometimes called the Compton electron. The remaining energy leaves the atom as a scattered photon, sometimes called the Compton photon. A few more principles to remember. Compton scattering occurs at all energy levels, but it becomes the predominant or the main interaction at high energies. Compton scattering increases the patient dose because of ionization. It increases the bystander dose because scatter is being created. And last of all, Compton scattering decreases the image quality because it decreases image contrast.